While contemplating the objects of the sense, a person develops attachment for them. And from such attachment, love develops, and from love, anger arises. For what? One who is not Krishna conscious is subjected to material desires while contemplating the object of senses. The senses require real engagement, and if they are not engaged in the transcendental loving service of the Lord, they will certainly seek engagement in the service of materialism.
Yes, here is the secret of yoga system. The yoga, indriya samyama. The real purpose of yoga is to control the senses. Our material activities means to engage the sense in some particular objective or enjoyment. That is our material engagement. And yoga system means that you have to control the senses and detach the senses from material enjoyment or material pleasure and pains and divert it, focusing towards seeing the super soul Vishnu within yourself. That is the real purpose of yoga. Yoga does not mean, of course, in the beginning there are different rules and regulations, sitting posture, just to bring the mind under control. But they are not end themselves. The end is to stop the material engagement and begin spiritual engagement. So here it is explained. Go on reading.
In the material world, everyone, including Lord Shiva and Lord Rama, to say nothing of other demigods in the heavenly planet, is subjected to the influence of dense objects.
Sense objects. Yes.
Sense objects. And the only method to get out of this bubble of material existence is to become Krishna conscious.
It is learned from Vedic literature that, of course, they are showing us Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma. They are also sometimes attracted by sense objects. Just like Lord Brahma, his daughter Saraswati. Saraswati is considered to be the most perfect form of beauty, womanly beauty, Saraswati. So, Lord Brahma became enchanted by the beauty of his daughter. Just to show us the example that even personalities like Lord Brahma sometimes become enchanted. This Maya is so strong. He forgot that she is my daughter. Then, to penance this, Brahma had to quit the body. These stories are there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Similarly, Lord Shiva also, when Krishna appeared before him in Mohini Murti. Mohini Murti, Mohini means the most enchanting, beautiful, womanly form. Lord Shiva also became mad of her. So, wherever she was going, Lord Shiva was chasing. And it is stated that while chasing Mohini Murti, Lord Shiva had discharged him. So, these examples are there, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Devijisa gunamai mamaya durutya. The whole material energy is enchanting every one of us by this beauty, the womanly beauty. Actually, there is no beauty. It is illusion. Shankaracharya said that you are after this beauty, but have you analyzed this beauty? What is the beauty? It is the wrong. Rakta mangsa vikaram. It is just like our student Govindadasi and Naranara are molding plaster of Paris. At this time there is no attraction. But this plaster of Paris, when it is nicely painted, it is so attractive. Similarly, this body is combination of blood and muscles and veins. If you cut the upper portion of your body as soon as you see inside, These all are not first horrible things. But outwardly so painted by the illusory color of Maya, it is very attractive. And that is attracting our senses. This is the cause of our bondage. We are being bound up by some false illusory beauty of this world. Mirage. The exact example is mirage. What is mirage? Reflection of the sunlight on the desert appears like water. Where is water there? There is no water. The animal, thirsty animal, is after the mirage. Oh, here is water, I will be satisfied. Similarly, we are hankering after, running after the mirage. There is no peace, there is no happiness. Therefore, we have to divert our attention back to God. Don't run after this mirage. Just turn back to God, back to Krishna. That is our purpose. Don't engage your senses in illusory material beauty. Just apply your senses to Krishna, the real beauty. That is Krishna consciousness.
Lord Shiva wants us to be in meditation, but when the beautiful lady, Parvati, agitated him with sense pleasure, he agreed to propose, and as a result, Kartikeya was born.
Ah, here is Kartikeya present. Yes. Hare Krishna, gone.
When Hari Das Thakur, the young devotee of the Lord, he was similarly allured by the incarnation of Maya Devi.
Now here is the difference. Lord Shiva, he is the greatest of the demigod. He was also allured by Parvati, and as a result of this attraction, this boy Kartikeya was born. That was the, what is called, conspiracy of the demigod, that unless one son is born out of the seminar of Lord Shiva, it is impossible to conquer the demons. So Kartikeya is considered the commander-in-chief of the demigods. But here another example. Haridas Thakur was young boy, about 24 years old, and he was chanting Hare Krishna, and the landlord in that village, he was very much envious of Haridas Thakur. He conspired and engaged one prostitute to defy him. So the prostitute then agreed, and at dead of night, a very beautiful dress, and she was young, and tried to captivate Haridas Thakur, but he was not captivated. That is the difference. A Krishna conscious person, even an ordinary person, not in the level of Lord Shiva or Lord Brahma, he is never conquered by Maya. But one who is not fully in Krishna consciousness, either he may be Lord Shiva or Lord Brahma, he will be conquered by Maya. What to speak about it? This is the position. Go on. When Haridas Thakur was a young devotee of the Lord,
he was allured by the incarnation of Maya Devi. But Haridas easily passed the test because of his unalloyed devotion to Lord Krishna. A sincere devotee of the Lord learns to hate all material sense enjoyment due to his higher taste of spiritual enjoyment in the association of the Lord. That is the secret of success.
Param dishtani vartate. Param, if you get better things, you give up inferior quality. That is our nature. Just like our students, American students, they were all accustomed to meat eating. But now, another student, she is preparing the sweet balls, ISKCON ball, and then forgetting it. They do not like any more meat eating. They have got better engagement, sweet balls. Similarly, that is the way. When you get better engagement, we are hankering after pleasure, anandamaya vyasa, Every living entity is seeking after pleasure. That is its nature. You cannot stop. If you stop, just like a child is seeking after some enjoyment, he is breaking something. Enjoyment. But it is not that he is breaking, but he is simply enjoying that break. Similarly, we do not know what is enjoyment in this material concept of life. We are breaking and building. In your country, I have seen several places. Nice building is dismantled. And again, in that very place, another building is placed. You see? Breaking and building. Breaking and, this building is old. Breaking. The same child is placed. You see? Simply wasting engagement. The valuable time of this human. Breaking and building. Breaking and building. This motor car is useless. Another 69 model. And thousands of people are engaged in the 69 model. What is that? In essence, breaking and building. Breaking and building. Just like the child. So unless one has got better engagement, Krishna consciousness, surely they will be engaged in this breaking and building. Child. Parangishtanagat. So far, our students of Krishna consciousness, they are trying to get 2 hours more than 24 hours. There were so many engagements. So unless one is engaged in Krishna consciousness, he must be in the Maya's engagement. Same thing. People may eulogize such engagement. He is so money mad. He has dismantled such nice building and again constructed another nice building. So, this is very nice in material estimation. But in spiritual estimation, they are simply wasting time. Hari Hari Vi Phale Janama Vainu. That song. Manusya Janama Paiya Radha Krishna Nam Hajiya Janiya Suniya Vishakhainu. Knowingly, purposefully, I am drinking poison. Poison? Why poison? Wasting time of this valuable human form of life is drinking poison. Just like a man drinks poison, he does not know what is his next life. He is going to become a ghost. For years together, he will not have this material body as punishment. You have seen, Gaurisundar has written one ghost article in our backyard in England, that ghost who fought with Cromwell, there is still fighting. At night there is sound of fighting going on. So, poison means this human form of life is the chance to get into Krishna consciousness and go back to Godhead. But if we do not engage in this Krishna consciousness, simply engage in this breaking and constructing, then we are simply drinking poison. That means next life, I will be thrown into the cycle of birth and death in the 88,400,000 species of life, and my life is spoiled. We do not know for how many millions of years I'll have to travel in that cycle of birth and death. That would be poison. Janiya Sunya Bishop. I know. I am hearing. Still. Janiya Sunya Bishop. Just like a thief. Janiya Sunya. These words are very significant. Janiya means knowing and Sunya means hearing. So a habituated thief, he knows that if I steal, I shall be put into jail. And he has heard from scriptures that don't steal, then he will be put into hell. So, he has heard from the scriptures and he has seen practically, he has experienced practically, but still as soon as he is freed from the prison life, he again commits the same mistake. Janiya Sunya Bishakhan. We know, we are hearing from the scriptures, from authority, Vedic literature, that I have got this miserable conditional body, material body, to suffer 3 folds of material misery. Still, I am not very much anxious how to stop this repetition of birth and death. I am drinking poison. Janiya Sariya Vishakaya. Hari Hari Di Phale Janavava. These songs are very instructive. Purposefully, we are drinking poison. God.
One would not therefore Krishna conscious, however powerful it may be, controlled and sent by artificial repression, is sure ultimately to fall. The slightest thought of sense pleasure will drive him to gratify his desire. 63. From anger, delusion arises, and from delusion, bewilderment of memory. When memory is bewildered, intelligence is lost. And when intelligence is lost, one walks down again into the material pool.
Our position is, we are constituted of this body. Body means the senses. And the controller of the senses are the, what is called, driver. Driver of the senses is the mind. And mind is conducted thinking, feeling and willing, the psychology, the science of psychology. That is being conducted under intelligence. And above the intelligence, I am sitting. I am a spirit soul. So, how we become a victim of this maya that is described here, that from anger, delusion arises, and from delusion, bewilderment of memory, I have forgotten completely that I am not this body. I am spirit soul. I am Brahmasmi. I am part and parcel of the Supreme Brahman, spirit, absolute whole, that I have forgotten. And when memory is bewildered, and as soon as I forget that I am spirit soul, I identify myself with this material world, illusion. Intelligence is lost. I should have used my intelligence to conduct the activities of the mind, thinking, feeling and willing. And because my mind is not controlled, my senses are not controlled, therefore I am fallen. This is the analysis of the whole bodily construct. God.
One who can control his senses by regulated principles and who is free from attachment and aversion can attain the mercy of God.
Yes. We have fallen down. How we have fallen down? We have fallen down to the platform of sense India. Therefore, we have to begin rising up from the senses, controlling of the senses. That is the way of self-realization. Either you practice yoga or practice bhakti, devotional service. The beginning is to control the senses. So the yogis and other methods, they are trying to control the senses by force. I shall go to the Himalaya. I shall not see any more beautiful woman. I shall close down my eyes. These are forced. You cannot control your senses. There are many instances. You don't require to go to Himalaya. You just remain in Los Angeles City and engage your eyes to see Krishna. You are more than a person who has gone to Himalaya. You will forget all other things. This is our question. You don't require to change your position. You engage your ear for hearing Bhagavad Gita as it is. You will forget all nonsense. You engage your eyes to see the beauty of the deity, Krishna. You engage your tongue for tasting Krishna prasada. You engage your legs to come to this temple. You engage your hands to work for Krishna. You engage your nose to smell the flowers offered to Krishna. Then where your senses will go is captivated all along. The perfection is sure. You don't require to control your senses. Force him. Don't see, don't breathe, don't do. No, you have to change the engagement, the status. That will help you. God.
It is already explained that one may externally control the senses by some artificial process, but unless the senses are engaged in the transcendental service of the Lord, there is every chance of a fall. Although the person in full Krishna consciousness may apparently be on a sensual plane, Actually, because of his being Krishna conscious, he has no attachment to or detachment from such sensual activity. The Krishna conscious person is concerned only with the satisfaction of Krishna and nothing else. Therefore, he is transcendental to all attachment or detachment. If Krishna wants, the devotee can do anything which is ordinarily undesirable. And if Krishna does not want, he will not do anything which he would have ordinarily done for his own satisfaction. Therefore, to act or not to act is within his control, because he acts only under the dictation of Krishna. This consciousness is the cause of mercy of the Lord, which the devotee can achieve in spite of being attached to the sensual life. 65. For one who is so situated, the threefold miseries of the material life exist no longer. In such a happy state, one's intelligence is steady. 66. One who is not in transcendental consciousness can have neither a controlled mind nor steady intelligence, without which there is no possibility of peace. And how can there be any happiness without peace?
67. Everyone in this material world, they are after peace, but they don't want to control the senses. It is not possible. Just like you are diseased and doctor says that you take this medicine, you take this diet, but you cannot control. You are taking anything you like against the instruction of the physician. Then how you can be cured? Similarly, we want cure of the chaotic condition of this material world. We want peace and prosperity. But we are not ready to control the senses. We do not know how to control the senses. We do not know the real yogic principle of controlling the senses. So there is no possibility of peace. Kuto shanti ajuptas. The exact word is there in the Bhagavad Gita. If you are not engaged in Krishna consciousness, there is no possibility of peace. Artificially, you may try for it. It is not possible. No.
67. As the boat of the water is swept away by a strong wind, even so, one of the senses in which the mind becomes fixed can carry away a man's intelligence.
Yes. Suppose on the Pacific Ocean, you are on a boat, on a nice sea. But if you have no controlling capacity, one wave of that Pacific Ocean can immediately bring you to the bottom of the sea. So this is required. We are in the midst of the Pacific Ocean of this Mayic world. Samsara Samudra. It is called Samudra. So at any moment, our boat can be topsy-turvy with. If we have no controlling power.
Yes. Therefore, O mighty arm, one whose senses are restrained from their objects is certainly a steady intelligence.
Yes, now, one whose senses are restrained. The human life is meant for restraining the senses. Tapa. This is called tapasya, penance. Suppose I am habituated to some type of sense gratification. Now I take to Krishna consciousness, my spiritual master or the scripture says, don't do this. So in the beginning, I may feel some inconvenience. But if you can tolerate that, that is tapasya. That is tapasya. Tapasya means, I am feeling some inconvenience bodily, but I am tolerating. That is called tapasya. And this human form of life is meant for that tapasya. Not that because my senses are demanding this satisfaction, I shall immediately offer. No. I shall train myself in such a way that my senses may demand, my dear sir, give me this facility. I will say, no, you cannot have. This is called Goshami or Sham. At the present moment, where everyone We have made our Swami, our master, the senses, and when you actually become the master of the senses, then you are Swami, or Goswami. That is the significance of Swami and Goswami. It is not the dress. One who has controlling power, one who is not dictated by the senses, one who is not servant of the senses. My tongue is dictating, please take me to that restaurant and eat sticks. What is that stick? Sticks? Steak? What is that spelling? So anyway, or that fried chicken. So tongue is dictating, but if you can control your tongue, no, I give you sweet ball, don't go there. Then you become master of yourself. The others are trying, they don't go there only. Oh, that is impossible. The tongue must have something beautiful, otherwise it is not possible. Very artificial. If the tongue gives something more beautiful than this fried cheek or cheek or cheek or that, it will stop. That is the policy. Our policy is that. We can give that what is good. Easy in fried with rice. How nice it is. And forget immediately. So this is the policy, Krishna consciousness. All the senses should be supplied something, not artificially stop it. That is not possible. That is not possible. Others, they are simply trying artificially to stop the function of the senses. No, that is not possible. Our policy is tatparatena nirmalam. You can purify the activities of the senses, being engaged in Krishna consciousness. Then senses will not disturb you. If you want to control the senses, you have controlled the tongue first of all. Then you will be able to control other senses very easily. So you give tongue the engagement of chanting Hare Krishna, and for tasting Krishna prasadam, you will find that your other senses are already controlled. This is the key of controlling our senses, the tongue. And if you give privilege and indulgence to the tongue, you will never be able to control others. This is the secret of controlling yourself. Right.
69. What is night for all beings is the time of awakening to self-control. And the time of awakening for all beings is the night, the introspective stage. Therefore, there are two classes of intelligent men. The one is intelligent in material activities, the sense gratification, and the other is introspective and awake to the cultivation of self-realization. Activities of the introspective stage or thoughtful man are night when persons materially absorbed. Materialistic persons remain asleep during such a night, due to their ignorance of self-realization. The introspective stage, however, remains alert in that night of the materialistic man.
Night means when people sleep, and day means when they are awake. This is the understanding of day and night. So, one, the materialistic person, they are sleeping in the matter of spiritual understanding. So, therefore, the activities which we find in daytime of the materialistic person, actually that is night. For the spiritualistic person, they see that these people, they got the facility of self-realization, this human form of life, how they are wasting by sleeping. And the materialistic person, they are saying, these Krishna conscious young boys, they have given up everything and they are chanting Hare Krishna. How nonsense they are sleeping. So in the vision of the materialistic person, these activities are night sleeping. And for the self-realized person, these activities are sleep. Just the opposite. They are seeing the Krishna conscious person as wasting time. And the Krishna conscious person is seeing them as wasting time. This is the belief. God.
But say you feel transcendental pleasure in the gradual advancement of spiritual culture, whereas the man in materialistic activity, being asleep or self-realization, dreams of variety of sense pleasure.
Yes, they're dreaming. Now we shall do this. Next time I shall have this. Next time I shall have this. Next time I shall kill that enemy. Next time I shall do this. They are planning like that.
sometimes happy and sometimes stressed in a sleeping condition. The introspective man is always indifferent to materialistic happiness and distress.
The introspective man is after self-realization and he knows very well. Suppose if I do in future such and such big business, such I can construct such big skyscraper house. But because he's introspective, he knows that what I shall do with all these things. As soon as I exit from the platform, everything remains here and I take another form of body, begins another life. That is introspection. The materialistic person, they cannot understand what is the future. They are thinking this body is everything. We have got this body and when it is finished, it is finished for all. These questions we have already discussed. But actually it is not. This is the first understanding of self-realization. That soul is eternal. It is not annihilated even after the annihilation of this body. This is the beginning of self-realization. And these people, they do not understand it. They don't care for it. And that is their sleeping. That is their miserable condition.
He goes on with his self-realization activity undisturbed by material reaction. Then, a person was not disturbed by the incessant flow of desire that enter like rivers into the ocean, which is ever being filled, but is always still, and alone achieve peace, and not the man who strives to satisfy such desire.
Now, here is the materialistic person, he has his desire. Suppose he is doing some business, he is getting money, so he fulfills his desire in materialistic way. But a Krishna conscious person, suppose he is doing in the same way, he is also planning, doing something after Krishna consciousness. So these two different spheres of activity are not on the same level. One.
Then a person who has given up all desires to sense gratification, who lives free from desire, who has given up all sense of proprietorship and is devoid of all ego, he alone can attain real peace.
Yes. The person who has given up all desires for sense gratification, we haven't got to kill our desire. How you can kill? Desire is constant companion of a living entity. That is the living symptom. Because I am living entity, you are living entity, you have got desire, I have got desire. Not this table. The table has no life, therefore it has no desire. The table cannot say that I am standing here for so many months, please move me to some other place. No, because it has no desire. But if I am sitting here for 3 hours, I got tired. Please remove me from, please get me another place. So, desire must be there because we are living. We have to change the engagement of, if we engage our desire for sense gratification, that is material. But if we engage our desire for acting on behalf of Krishna, that is all, free from all desire. This is the fact.
That is the way of spiritual and godly life. After attaining this event, being so situated, even at the hour of death, one can enter into the kingdom of God. Before, one can attain Krishna consciousness, the divine life at once, within a second, or one may not attain such a state of life, even after millions of births.
Several times, there are questions. So how long it will take to become Krishna conscious? I have also answered. Then in a second it can. The same thing is being explained. Go on.
It is only a matter of understanding and accepting the fact that Bhagavad Maharaj attained the state of life just a few minutes before his death by surrendering unto Krishna. Nirvana means the final process of materialistic life. According to Buddhist philosophy, there is only void in this material life. But the Bhagavad Gita teaches differently. Actual life begins after the completion of this material life. For growth material, it is sufficient to know that one has to end the materialistic way of life. But the person who is spiritually advanced, there is another life after this materialistic way. Therefore, before ending this life, if one fortunately becomes Krishna conscious, certainly he has once attained the stage of Brahman Nirvana. There is no difference between the kingdom of God and the devotional service of the Lord. Both of them are on the absolute plane. To be engaged in the transcendental loving service of the Lord is to have attained the spiritual kingdom. In the material world, there are activities of sense gratification, whereas in the spiritual world, there are activities of Krishna consciousness. Therefore, attainment of Krishna consciousness, even during this life, is immediate attainment of Brahman. And one who is situated in Krishna consciousness has certainly already entered into the kingdom of God. Srila Bhaktivedanta has summarized the second chapter of the Bhagavad Gita as being the contents for the whole text. In the Bhagavad Gita, the subject matters are Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga,
Jnana Yoga,
Bhakti Yoga. In the second chapter, Karma Yoga and Jnana Yoga have been clearly discussed, and the glimpse of Bhakti Yoga has also been given. Thus in the Bhaktivedanta Srila, the second chapter of the Srimad Bhagavad Gita, the matter of the conflict.
Thank you. Many questions? Yes.
Our goal is to use that to understand that a pure devotee like Prabhupada would not fall victim to my daily temptation, but even Lord Rama, Lord Shiva, might fall victim. I always thought that they were pure devotees of the Lord.
No. They are pure devotees, but their gunavata, just like Lord Brahma, is the supreme personality within this material universe. He is the father of all living entities. So, they are, of course, if we very scrutinizingly study, Haridas Thakur is in devotional service in greater position than Brahma. Although he is considered the incarnation of Brahma Haridas. So, we should not be disturbed when we see Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, he is captivated in that way. We should take this instruction that if Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva becomes victim of Maya sometime, what to speak of us? That we should be very, very careful. There is chance of fall down even in the status of Brahma and Shiva, what to speak about in any person. Therefore, we should be very strongly inclined to Krishna consciousness, like Haridas Thakur. Then we shall be able very easily to overcome the allurement of Maya. That is to understand. Not that Brahma showed that weakness. He is weak or he is less. No. That is for our instruction. Yes. Or first of all, yes.
It says that once you achieve enlightenment, once you go back to Krishna, that you don't fall down. But it is also said that we come from there originally. And we came from there. How do we fall?
Yes. Yeah, just like this example, that personalities like Brahma and Shiva, they also sometimes become victims of Maya. So, our potency of falling down is always there. Potency. And because we are part and parcel of God, And because we are now in the material world, it is to be understood that we have fallen down. But you cannot trace out the history when you have fallen down. That is impossible. But our position is marginal. At any moment we can fall down. That tendency is there. That will be called marginal. But one, that's like, it is very simple to understand. Everyone is prone to fall disease. Is it not? Now when you are diseased, there is no necessity of finding out the history when you become diseased. Your disease makes your treatment. That's all. Similarly, we are in the material condition of life. Just go on treating it. And as soon as you are cured, be careful not to fall down again. But there is chance of falling down again becoming diseased. Not that because you once become cured and there is no chance of becoming diseased again. There is chance. Therefore, you should be very much careful. Yes.
In the Bhagavad Gita, it says in verse 41 that Brahma is the understanding spiritual master. But I thought that all spiritual masters live forever. But Brahma doesn't live forever.
Yes, he lives forever. When change of body, you do not die. You live forever, I live forever. And death means you change this body. That's just like you change your dress. When you change your dress, it does not mean that you die. Similarly, change of this body does not mean actually death. Or to appear in a different body does not mean actually birth. There is no birth or death of the living entity. But the change of body is taking place in our material condition. That is taken as birth and death. Actually, there is no birth and death. Yes?
For one who worships Lord Buddha, is
there
anything else? For one who worships Lord Buddha,
yes.
In Bhaktivedanta, or some kind of devotional service, when he worships Lord Buddha, is there a plan for anything else? Like, Lord Buddha is the idol, or,
yes, there is a neutral stage, that is not planet, that is a marginal position between the spiritual world and the material world. But one has to come down again. Unless one enters into the spiritual sky and takes his situation in some of the spiritual planet, just like you fly in the sky, unless you get some planet, you'll have to come down again. You cannot fly all the day in the sky. That is not possible. That is neutral stage. Neither in other planet nor in this planet. Fly. How long you shall fly? You have to take some shelter. But if you have no shelter in the higher planet, then or higher situation, then you shall have to come down. The same example can be repeated. Suppose if you go in the outer space, just like the Sputnik man, they go sometime. People think, well, he has gone so high, so high. But he has not gone anywhere. He's coming down again. So it is called clapping. He has gone so high, so high. What is the use of going so high? You're coming down next moment. Because you have no power to enter into another planet. So what your machine, this Sputnik or this plane will do help you? You have to come down again. Rather you shall fall down in some Atlantic Ocean or Pacific Ocean, somebody will go and pick you up. Mm-hmm. This is your position. So the void is a means to fly in the sky and be puffed up. I have come so high, I have come so high. That policeman does not know how long he will keep in that high position. He will come down. This is Maya's attraction. You'll have to come down. That is, there is a verse in it. Janne ravindakha vimukta manina tayyastu bhavada vishuddha buddhaya aruchyakichina parampadam tata patanti adha anadita jusmadam bhaya. This is the prayer by Pandavas Maharaj. He said, my dear Lord, lotus eyed Aravindakha, Jay Anne, some third class man, They are very much proud of ending this material life, nirvana, or this impersonalism. Vimuktamanina is just simply falsely thinking that they have surpassed the clutches of Maya. Falsely. Vimuktamanina. Just like if you falsely think that I am the proprietor of this Los Angeles city, is it not your false thinking? Similarly, if anyone thinks that now I have attained Nirvana or I have merged into the Supreme, you may think like that. The mind is very strong. You may be puffed up by such false prestige. Vimuktamanina. The Bhagavad says, Tai asma bhavas abhisuddha buddha. But because they have not searched out your lotus feet, therefore their consciousness is impure, thinking I am something. Abhisuddha buddha, their intelligence, consciousness is not purified. Therefore, ariya kichena, they perform very severe practice. That's like the Buddhists, they have got very... Now, those are not practicing, that is different thing, but rules and things, Lord Buddha himself, he saw it. He left his everything and became engaged in simply meditation. Who is doing that? Nobody is doing that. Shankaracharya's first condition is that first of all you take sannyas, then you talk of becoming Nara. Who is taking sannyas? So they are simply falsely thinking. Actually, their intelligence is impure. Consciousness is impure. Therefore, in spite of such endeavorance, the result is arjakachena param. Although they go very high, say 25,000 miles or millions of miles up, they do not find any shelter. Where is moon, planet, where is earth, they come down again to a Moscow city, yes, or New York city, yes, sir. These are the examples. When they are high up, they take photographs, this planet is so, this Earth planet is so green, or so small, I am going down near night and seeing in 1 hour, 3 times near night. All right, very good. Please come down. Yes. My so strong, she is there, yeah, very good. You are very advanced in your scientific knowledge, but please come down. Come here. Otherwise, you are going to be put into the Atlantic Ocean. Yes, sir. And they will still be puffed up. Oh, you are making progress. In the next 10 years, you can purchase ticket and land in the moon. You know, in Russia, they sold land. They advertised that there is Sea of Moscow. Plunge our flag on the sea. These are propaganda. We cannot go even into the nearest planet, what to speak of the spiritual sky. If you actually serious are going to the spiritual sky and Vaikuntha Loka, then take this simple method, Hare Krishna. That's all. This is the gift of Lord Chaitanya. Namo Mahabharata. Therefore, Prabhupada Swami says, you are the greatest of all charitable persons, because you are offering the greatest boon, Krishna Prema Pradaya. You are offering love of Krishna, which will get me to the kingdom of Krishna. This is the greatest gift to the human society, but the foolish persons, they do not understand what comes from. Maybe this Agalamayo, the Maya is very strong. If we say that here is a small booklet, easy journey to other planet, they will not take it. They make plan of how to go in other planet by Sputniks. It is impossible. You cannot go anywhere. That is our condition life. Condition means you must stay here. You must stay here. Who is allowing to go other place? For coming to take the permanent visa of your country, I have to fight so much, and you are going to one planet, there is no visa. They will allow you only to enter. It is so easy thing. But they foolishly think that simply I am the monarch of all I serve. That's all. This planet is the monarch and all other planets, they are all subservient and they will satisfy our senses. This is foolishly.